Said the fight was shitty to begin with. It was even shittier when it actually happened. You know, if you see my last video, you know, I was going to eat. You know, I had some good food, man. Had a terrific cheesecake I'd never had before. Caramel, apple, some shit, man. It was delicious. You know, macaroni and cheese, greens, pasta salad, the whole nine, you know. It was great. It was great, best part of the night. I would have never spent a nickel on this fight. Like I said, I was going to eat. But I think that the truth is starting to come out now. You know, everybody wants to blame. You know, all the PacTars want to talk about Floyd won't fight, Floyd won't do this, Floyd won't step up. They already sent the contracts to Marquez for a fight before the Shane Mosley fight even happens. So who the fuck is really ducking who, you know? If you're gonna send a contract to somebody, why not send it to Floyd? That's who the contract should be going to, right? I don't know, I don't get it. Some bullshit to me. And the one thing I've always said, you know, like, if you look guilty and you smell guilty, you're probably guilty, you know? If a motherfucker told you, man, somebody stole my money, I just had $50 and five sitting on this damn, my bedroom dresser, and it's only three of us in the house, somebody got that shit. And I say, empty your pockets. And you say, nah, I'm not emptying my pockets. But you look guilty. Plain and simple, you look guilty, you know? Even if you didn't take it, what's your reason for not emptying out your pockets? Because there's some shit in there that you don't want somebody to see. Whole thing with the drug test shit, man. You know, people always, oh, it's cool. You know, why he gonna change the rules? Fighters change the rules all the time. They make weight limits. They even got junior weight limits. You know what I'm saying? 5, 6, 7 pounds. That don't stop a motherfucker from saying, well, you should come in at this weight. You can't come in over this weight. But a motherfucker asks for it. Drug test, and motherfuckers want to say he's scared. How ridiculous, dog. We talking about a motherfucker hitting you upside the face with the intentions of hurting you, and just to make sure that everything is on the up and up. That's a bitch move. We ain't talking about hitting the baseball or riding a bicycle or fucking swimming or running. You know what I'm saying? I could run faster than you. We talking about a motherfucker trying to intentionally bring bodily harm to your ass. You know what I'm saying? And let's make sure everything on the up and up is a motherfucker being scared. Kills me. I don't get it. I don't get it at all. Fight was shitty. But they picked Shitty Shane Mosley to fight with. What did you expect? You know, I didn't expect nothing different. I expected, that's exactly what I expected. I expected this shit to be a dud. I expected CBS to be regretful for even agreeing to do any of this shit. I didn't watch any of the 360s because the fight was some bullshit to begin with. And the fight was a fucking dud. Motherfuckers was texting me all night. You know what I'm saying? This shit is sad. This shit is boring as fuck. This shit is terrible. And I said that. And I said that this shit probably was going to backfire in Showtime's face because they're going to have a hard time marketing. How the fuck do you make the casual fan want to see another fucking pay-per-view? That whole shit was garbage. The fucking whole pay-per-view was... The Arce-Vasquez fight was pretty good. I will say, that was a pretty damn good fight. But the pay-per-view as a whole fucking sucked. It was some fucking bullshit. The best thing about it was the ring card, girls. You know? But the fucking fight, this main event, was some bullshit from the jump. And, like I said, why are we not getting fucking a contract being sent to Floyd? He's a free agent. He don't got no promotional team. You know, no ties to that Golden Boy. He can do this shit on his own. Send Floyd the contract. Let's get the fucking fight. Take the test. Make it happen, shit. You know? At one point in time, I thought that Pacquiao would beat Floyd. And I wanted to see that fight so bad because I wanted to see Floyd get his fucking head knocked off, too. Now, some bullshit. Once again, these motherfuckers go to the oldest fucking fighter, the fighter with the least resistance, you know what I'm saying, between the three of these fighters. They say, they send a contract out, or they're looking at offers to fight Marquez, Bradley, and Zab fucking Judah. Come on, man. And the order goes Marquez, Judah, Bradley. Because that's the order that it goes in from the least resistance to the most resistance. I love Marquez, but Marquez is old. He's been in a lot of wars. And he's the oldest out of the three. And the smallest. Zab Judah. Zab Judah looked like shit in his last fight. He got lucky and knocked out a guy that I had never even heard of. He got lucky. Got a knockout. Which was some bullshit. But okay, he won his fight. But he still looked like shit. Tim Bradley, the undefeated motherfucker, who just beat three straight undefeated motherfuckers, who's dying for a fucking big fight. He can't get one because everybody keeps screwing him around. He'll be the last motherfucker to get picked. But the one motherfucker that everybody wants to see Manny Pacquiao fight is the one motherfucker not being mentioned. It's all right. I'm done with this shit. People wonder why boxing is dying. This shit is fucking hard. It's garbage, man. It's hard for me to watch any of this shit now. You know what I'm saying? We got motherfucking Saul Alvarez fighting Ryan Rhodes. Come on, man. Put him in there with somebody. Fuck it. Chavez Jr. just sucking the fucking pesos out of the Mexican people, man. Some bullshit, dog. Some fucking bullshit. Some fucking bullshit. Boxing died when De La Hoya died, man. You know, the one thing I can say about Oscar is he fought everybody, all the best. Whoever the best was, he fought the best fucking middleweight at the time. He fought the best fucking welterweights at the time. Fought the best fucking lightweights at the time. Fought all the best fighters that he could possibly fucking fight. You know? And that shit just don't happen no more. This is some bullshit. Some bullshit any way you look at it. And shitty Shane Mosley. Shitty Shane Mosley. If your ass don't sit the fuck down and retire. You can't even pick the right fucking fights, man. Man, this is some bullshit. Oh yeah, message to the Pac Tars. Even with Andre Berto losing to Victor Ortiz, even in losing to Victor Ortiz, why is he not considered a challenger still to fight Pacquiao? I mean, Lord knows, if we had to put money on it, who the fuck has a better chance of beating Pacquiao? Ortiz? I mean, fuck. Berto? Or motherfucking Zab Judah? Come on. Fucking retread? What the fuck? Zab Judah? Come on, dog. You mean to tell me Zab Judah is in the running? Zab Judah? Alright. Not Victor Ortiz, the welterweight champion. Not Andre Berto. Motherfucking Zab Judah. Okay. How about the fact that the next three opponents lined up, none of them are welterweights. How about that? How about two junior welterweights and a fucking lightweight, a blown up lightweight at that?